Welcome back to another episode of Andrew Plays. As always, I'm your host, Andrew Ambrose, and I hope you're having a fantastic day. I don't usually record Andrew Plays episodes this late in the day, or rather, late at night. Right now it's 8:39 p.m. I usually try to record these earlier in the day, at the earliest, like, noon or something. But I wanted to have a video this week for you guys, and I've been procrastinating a little too much, though I am working on something currently. So, I'm doing another Andrew Plays, and well, as you could tell, today we're going to be playing Bosconian, but not just any version of Bosconian, the Sharp X1 version of Bosconian, which is a pretty unique version of the game and is pretty cool. Obviously, the best version of Bosconian would have to be the Sharp X60,000 version, especially because of its arrange mode with brand new music, composed by, well, partially composed by Yuzo Koshiro, who you might know as the guy who did the music for the East games and the Streets of Rage games, and is also the co-founder of Ancient. But yeah, this X68000 version is also pretty damn cool, and this is a version I'll be playing for you guys. Bosconian is one of my favorite Namco games ever, and is was so unappreciated, and in a way is very underrated. It deserves a lot more love. Like, you want to know how much I love this game? I consider this game better than Galaga. And I know a lot of you guys out there love Galaga, and like, I used to love Galaga. Nowadays, I think it's alright. But Bosconian, man, this game is on a whole other level. But I'll spare you my weird opinions and stuff, and we'll get right to the action with Bosconian for Sharp X1. And of course, you can see this was done by Dempa. Blast off. Sounds better than in the MSX version, which is also a great version of Bosconian. So, yeah, for those who don't know, the way you play Bosconian is quite simple. You're flying around this space, and there are these green space stations all over the place, and your goal is to destroy all of them, without getting yourself destroyed, of course. The way you destroy them, you either shoot into the red core, or you blow up the six sections of the station in order to blow it up. And as you get later on into the levels, a lot of the space stations will have shutter doors that'll open and close, making it harder to directly kill it with the weak area. But blowing up a bunch of the space stations right through the middle is just so satisfying and euphoric, in my opinion. And I imagine it is for a lot of people, too. And well, you can tell the graphics in this specific version, they look very nice. But the X1 had great colors. And this is a good example of that. Like, it's just so vibrant with the way everything looks. The game itself, it plays very well. Of course, the scrolling isn't perfect. Like, it's not smooth, but it's not, like, jagged. Like, it's perfectly fine. The game still plays well enough. You can move in all, you can do all 8 directions, including that, like, all the diagonals and cardinals. It's just a great, solid version of the game. But from my recollection, I think there's a few other extra stuff in here. But I forget what exactly it is. I think there was some extra stuff in here. I forget exactly. But, yeah. And, about the Galaga thing earlier, another thing you might not know about Bosconian, I'm sure some of you already know this, but this game was made on the exact same hardware as Galaga. And, coincidentally enough, another one of my favorite Namco titles, Zevius. You know how much I love Zevius. That was also made on Galaga hardware. Both this and Zevius were on Galaga hardware. Which really was remarkable hardware, especially for the time. I'm pretty great at this game. Like, my best score on Bosconian, which I got sometime in 2019, was, like, more than 200,000 points. I forget the exact score, but I still have a picture of it on my phone. Of course, I'm playing with this third-party Switch controller connected to my computer. And, well, the analog stick on this is good. It gets the job done. And, well, using a analog stick is very ideal for Bosconian because you need all those 8 directions to properly move around. Same for Zevius and a bunch of other 8-directional movement games, like Fozon. You guys like Fozon? That was a pretty cool game, and the music is awesome. And, coincidentally enough, it was also made by Namco. And let us not forget another classic 8-directional game, which was not made by Namco, was instead made by Nichibutsu, Crazy Climber. Actually, not only used 1 8-directional joystick, but 2. 2 8-directional joysticks. It's a game not only unique for the time, but even for now, it's pretty damn unique, and it's also very underrated and deserves a lot more love. I love Crazy Climber, and I even have it on the Switch, the arcade version, and I hope to get the Crazy Climber 2 Arcade Archives release as well on the Switch. But in the meantime, I still have Old Reliable, the original from 1980. And of course, there's also the cool Famicom version, which I also really love. Though I haven't played it in a really long while. I should play it again. Hell, I don't think I even have it on my Wii FCEUGX Famicom NES emulator. I should put it on there, on my Wii SD card, so I can play it on there with 2 Wii remotes in hand. Ooh, extra life. The space station's over there. What do you think that looks like? Is that supposed to be a constellation? Because, like, you might have noticed in one of the earlier rounds, it was in the shape of the Big Dipper, which, of course, houses the North Star. But I don't know if this is also supposed to be a constellation of sorts. Hokuto, Shakuretsu Ken. You gotta kill the spy ships, or else the game will go code red, and then everyone will come in and attack you from everywhere. Yep, this was before the days of Team Fortress 2. Bloody spy! Sorry, that was a bad impression. There was this old Calvin and Hobbes video I used to watch when I was a kid. It was actually my very first exposure to Team Fortress 2, as a matter of fact. At least I think it was. The earliest I can remember, at least. But, like, it was a video... it's not on YouTube anymore. I tried looking. I could not find it. I couldn't even find it in an archive search, though I might have to look harder. It was called Calvin is Spy. And it was like a Calvin and Hobbes comic. And it featured a few voice clips from Team Fortress 2. Like, I distinctly remember, like, the opening part of it. Like, there's someone's sentence mixed, I think it was Heavy, saying, "Calvin is spy!" If someone could find that video again and put it up again, I would be genuinely happy, because I haven't seen that video in years, but I still remember it. Calvin and Hobbes was my childhood, big part of my childhood, and a massive influence on my imagination and just me as a person. Like, it has to be the greatest newspaper comic ever. Even more than Garfield, which I'm also big into, though I'm more into the animated Garfield stuff, like the TV specials Garfield and Friends, and I used to watch Garfield's show when I was a kid on the Cartoon Network. I enjoyed that too. I haven't seen any full episodes in a long while. But yeah, it's cool. Not as good as Garfield and Friends, but still cool. Rest in peace, Lorenzo Music. And also, I forgot, also Peanuts. Peanuts is also a fantastic comic, newspaper comic. Though I also watch all of the animated stuff more. Guys, yes, Calvin and Hobbes. Freaking awesome comic. You guys remember Spaceman Spiff? I freaking remember Spaceman Spiff. That was awesome. I broke 100k. Well, in points. In subscribers, I'm still stuck at less than 400, but I'm getting there. Gotta give things time, let the ball roll, and don't let it disrupt your passion. Yeah, one of the key tricks that I've picked up, that I've discovered with this game, you gotta use the diagonals. And also your back shot. Like, one of the things I love about this game is that you fire both in front and behind you. That really comes in handy. As a matter of fact, I've read somewhere on Strategy Wiki that it's usually best to try to use your backward, that your rear shot to take out enemies, because you don't have to worry about running away from anybody, because you can just shoot them down and kill them, and it's awesome. See, like right here, I just use my back and I destroy that guys as they're chasing me. The only time you need to turn back is when you're about to run into something, like the space stations, or like a mine, or something. Also, I noticed with this version that there's a bit of a, like normally when you destroy the last green station in most versions of this game, like everything stops and then you move to the next level. But here, it continues on for a short while, and then it stops, and then you go on to the next thing. Oh yeah, I love this round, because all you do is you just, first you shoot the, first you take out that, you blow up this vertical one. Well, don't do that, but don't get yourself blown up, but... Yeah, these pesky mines are an annoyance. That image of them exploding is burned into my brain for the rest of time. Same with the explosion from Galaxian when you get blown up. Pick them off. Yo, bonus! Yeah, you just blow up the vertical one, and then it's straight forward to the end, baby. Just keep going in a straight line. Ooh, and also occasionally dodge bullets and occasional attack formation, but then continue on. Excuse me. There you go. See? Straight through. I love that round. It's probably my favorite of the game. Now it's starting to get difficult. Now they're starting to crowd, and now there's bullets from everywhere. What is this, Gradius? Speaking of which, I've been playing a lot of Gradius games lately. Especially, I beat Life Force on NES. Like, when I was younger, I always stayed away from it, because it always looked really hard. And while it is hard, it's not really that hard. It's it's fairly easy with the Konami code and the 30 extra lives. Honestly, now I've gone back to it, I can say it's really damn good. Though, my favorite shooting game, which I also recently beat and played for the first time, actually, will be Compile's amazing Gunnak, which is a sort of sequel, sort of parody of their Zanac and Alesta games. It's just so well done. Like, the music, the gameplay, so many things are so well done that it is just... Oh, man, Gunnak, beautiful game. I've beaten it, but I'll definitely try to get it on a cartridge just so I can have it and play it whenever I want on my actual NES. Since I don't usually got the money to buy physical games anymore. But I do try. Though lately I've been just more sticking towards getting modern games on my Switch. Though most of them are retro anyway. Retro games re-released or like compilations. And occasional new stuff. That's usually tied to some older property or something, or, you know, whatnot. I think, oh shit, my foot's falling asleep. Diagonal attack formation. Good thing I have a diagonal blaster. Smoke them bitches. 1500. Just picking them off like flies. Ah! Yeah, and I also forgot to mention the guys that they start coming out of them, so you have to be careful not to get hit by them as you're trying to shoot the core. Destroy the core! There I go again with the Gradius connection. But yeah, I meant to also mention Gradius. Not just Life Force, but also, I've been playing a lot of the MS, I also recently beat PC Engine Gradius, which is easily the best version of the game ever for any platform, even better than the arcade version. But I also been playing MSX Gradius and MSX Gradius 2. And I must say, MSX Gradius 2, really, really solid title. Especially because of the secret backup system that allows you to retain your power-ups after dying. And the only way you do that is by putting Maze of Gallius, another Konami title, into the second slot on an MSX computer. And then having the Gradius 2 in the first slot, and you'll get a backup of all of the power-ups you received after you die. And that's really helpful, and honestly, I think it makes it really, really enjoyable. I don't know if the backup system is also in the Sharp X68000 version, which I have played, but I'll need to check again to see if it's there. I hope it is, because that version is like a step up from the MSX version. Like, obviously, it's more like an arcade-style game. Like, smoother scrolling, better graphics, better music. I mean, the music is already fantastic on the MSX2 thanks to Konami's amazing SCC sound chip. But, the X68000 pulls off some fantastic music. As a matter of fact, one of my friends, Death Engine 2, they told me recently that Capcom was such a big fan of X68000 that they actually used it as I think they based the CPS arcade hardware after the X68000 and used the X68000 as the workstations for developing CPS arcade titles. Honestly, that's really cool. And I don't blame them for doing that. Because X68000 lives up to its colloquial name of the God Computer. Because it truly is a godly computer, especially for the time for which it was released. This game owns, man. It owns! I can dance all day! Try hit me, come on! Thank you. Yeah, so I like to play Baskonian. I just like to rush, hunting people down and killing them. I mean, my heart's beating, my hands are shaking, my hands are sticking, but I'm still shooting, and I'm still getting them headshots, like, boom, headshot, boom, headshot, boom, headshot. By the way, anyone who gets that reference, you get a veteran discount, like, straight up, veteran discount, like, mad respect, veteran discount on my channel. Your head explode! Ooh, now, oh, I cracked 200k, yo, dude! That's epic! Yeah, major claustrophobia right here. You're trapped within the confines of these space stations. And the only way out is by blowing them to kingdom come. Duh. Suckers are killing me. I'll get him. Yeah! Got him. This game is just bliss. Like, whenever I come back to this, I'm in for a great time. Hell, if there were an alternate universe where I was crazier and had a lot more money, I would probably buy an X68000 plus a copy of that version of this game, because... hot damn. Also, if I'd like to give a quick shout-out to one of my cool friends, Gunma Wong. He's really cool guy. He's big in the shooting games, especially Konami ones like Gradius. And he actually owns, not one, but two X68000s. Well, one of them is broken, I think. But, hey, at least one is operational, and it is pretty awesome. So, he also makes some awesome art on Twitter. So, definitely check that out. And also, I might as well also shout out NamcoKid47. I hope I didn't get the number wrong. He's probably the most knowledgeable mind that I know when it comes to Namco stuff. He's so knowledgeable about Namco, he even knows business figures about it. Like, freaking business figures. Like, hell, he's even writing a book about Namco's history. Or at least I think he's planning on doing that, or something, and like, I forget exactly. Not to mention, he's also contributed very much to some great contributions to some Wikipedia pages, like ones about Namco, and others. Like, he's just a cool guy, like, major props to him for what he's done. You know what? Actually, I think this is a better score than what I did back in 2019. Like, this is better than that. I guess this version of the game is a lot easier. I guess it's a little slower, so it's a little easier to play. So I guess if you're a beginner, this might be the one you want to check out. But still, like, man, I think I'm doing better with this than I was doing with the other version, with the version I was playing all those years ago when I got that really big score, my best possible score. Woo! Kill the bloody spy! Ooh, extra life! It's Christmas time, be happy. Wait a minute, Christmas was almost three months ago. What am I on about? Yeah, I'm gonna get that guy. Spy, bloody spy! Ah, he blew me up. He blew me up. Bakuhatsu. Ryuken Bakuhatsu. Huh, that's weird. They start me all the way over there and place all the guys in one crowded spot over there. I guess it's like, it's a big thing and I have to enter in as they fire upon me with all their little pellets. Honestly, the bullets in Bosconian, they kind of look more like, they like look like styrofoam packing peanuts. If you, like, look at them. Those could easily be, like, grains of rice or styrofoam pellets. I don't know, it's just fun to think about. But damn, those pellets, they're deadly. They can kill you in a single touch. You can blow up an entire spaceship. And also, if you have animals, they can choke on it if you're not careful. If you leave them on the floor. Also, I dodged a bunch of bullets and you didn't die. So that's cool. Ooh, extra life! Oh, 300,000! Okay, this is definitely better than I've ever done in any version of this game. Hot damn. Fresh hot damn on a silver platter. With a side of Jesus Christ. And holy ma- And a side of mackerel. And a little bit of beef. Holy cow. And a bit of- I don't know what else. Jump, yeah. Bloody spy! Kill him. Shit, don't let him get away. Oh, thank God. Thank goodness. Oh, that guy almost killed me. Yeah, it's satisfying when there's just one last thing left you can just blow, is go after it and boom. Blast off! The blast off voice clip sounds a lot clearer here than in the MSX version. Ah, there we go. I bit the dust right there. High score of the day, 315,530. That's a score to be proud of, definitely. Well, that's it for today's episode of Andrew Plays. I had a great time doing that, man. I haven't played Bosconi in a while, but man, this version is a fantastic version. It's definitely a lot on the easier side. So if you're like a beginner, you might want to check this one out, other than like the arcade version or the MSX version or X68000 version. But most versions of whether you play Bosconian is a fantastic game, well worth your time, and deservedly part of the pantheon of classic arcade titles, especially Namco titles. And anyways, I really enjoyed that, and I hope you enjoyed this Let's Play as much as I did playing the game and talking about it to you guys. This was a fun episode, I think. But anyway, all that aside, thank you guys for watching once again, and I hope to see you next time for another fun video. And as always, I'm your host, Andrew Ambrose, and I will catch you later.